Lisa, dear friend, please come up here.
I'm vertically challenged. Thank you, Julie, for those kind remarks. I was truly moved when I was asked to be the recipient of the 2014 Sondra D. Bender Community Leadership Award. To join the remarkable women who have been given this honor in the past, including Julie herself, and my other friends, is especially humbling to me. I have known Julie Bender Silver since I moved back to the Washington area in 1983, and through her, I got to know her wonderful parents. Sondra was an incredible woman with a unique passion for helping her community. She and my buddy Howard have made a difference in countless ways in this city and beyond. To receive an award devoted to community leadership really resonates with me, because anyone who knows me can attest I truly am a hands-on person. When I began to serve on the board of the Jewish Foundation for Group Homes in the 1980s, my favorite part was connecting personally with the residents and having dinner with them. Before I became president of JFGH, I took a leadership course provided by our Jewish Federation of Greater Washington. Our professor, Dr. Erica Brown, said to us, "Find a mentor." I have been fortunate to have had many wonderful mentors in my life. My grandmother, Mary Oshinsky Snyder, not only taught me how to knit, but she also taught me through her life and examples the importance of tzedakah. By taking me to meetings with her, I saw how she gave warm and genuinely, which empowered me to try to do the same. My grandmother grew up poor and never owned a doll, but yet always knew to put a penny in the pushka. I found another mentor when I made a career shift from being a dental hygienist to working with flowers. At that time, the only flowers I knew were petunias and impatiens, so I began to take classes. For one class, we went on a field trip to a greenhouse. I was a kid in a candy store. No joke. I never knew there were so many flowers. It was there that I met a wonderful and knowledgeable man, Al Smith. I bombarded him with 100 questions on the spot. I was so eager and excited about the flowers that he took me under his wing and taught me about horticulture and the dynamics of establishing a business. He gave me encouragement and confidence to be bold. With his guidance, my business, Pots and Pansies, was born. Thank you for teaching me to fly, Al. Research has shown that daughters with fathers who encourage their achievement are often able to go further. I know that for a fact because my father believed in me. Prior to graduating college, he told my siblings and me that we needed to stand on our own. At the time of my divorce, he said it again and told me he was not going to support me. That motivated me, and I made Pots and Pansies a success. When I went through the divorce, my self-esteem level was at 0%. It took a lot of hard work to gain it back. Thank you, Dad, for empowering me. I love you. Another person who has been a role model for me is Vivian Bass. Just watching her showed me that what real leadership was, as she exuded energy for the Jewish Foundation for Group Homes. JFGH's mission is to serve individuals with developmental disabilities. She helped me grow, taught me how to advocate with government officials, and how to have more of a voice in the Jewish community. She was a catalyst involving me in Leadership Montgomery and the Ivy Mount School. Thank you, Vivian. My pearl of wisdom is this. I hope you will go out of your way to find mentors to help you realize your full potential. I am determined to pay it forward by mentoring other women so they can flourish. Be well and be strong. Thank you.